Welcome to ECN Trade Daily Video. Before we begin, it should be noted that any advice is of a general nature only, and that your personal circumstances have not been taken into consideration.
Hello everyone, my name is Rob Clayton and thank you for joining me. Well, on Friday, the market was relatively strong in terms of a weaker US dollar after the US job numbers come out unexpectedly higher. The dollar index, which measures the greenback strength against a basket of six major currencies, is taking its third tumble since posting 11-month highs, which was seen around 107, and now trading at the close of New York at 105.80. The surprisingly strong report on the US job numbers was quite a surprise to many, as the September job numbers blew unexpectedly out of the water after coming in almost double the forecast of 170,000, which indicated that the US job market is still kicking off plenty of heat. Now posting its 33rd consecutive month of job growth in the United States, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics job report, surged by a surprisingly high 336,000, its most impressive monthly employment gain since January, and is significantly above August's net gain of 227,000 jobs added, which was revised up by 40,000 from the initial estimates. However, wages appear to be cooling off somewhat after the average hourly earnings was unchanged from the previous month's release at 0.2% in September, bringing the annual gain, though, of 4.2%. The unemployment rate held steady at 3.8% in August, and also the number was the same for September. Looking ahead to this week, the market is somewhat light in the Australian economic outlook, but the US looks now towards the core PPI, and also we've got the FOMC meeting minutes. Along with that, we've got in the UK GDP, and also we've got the main event being the core CPI in the US month on month and year on year. And also in China, we have the CPI year on year and PPI. Along with that, we wrap up with the preliminary EuroM consumer sentiment as well. So looking at the technicals, we can see now that the last 3 days have been relatively strong since bouncing off that key support level 62.80, and now posting the bullish outside range, they could see further gains and on towards this 60-day moving average around 65 cents. Looking to the technicals though, they are firming up and therefore do support at least a firmer start to this week, and looking towards 64.5 as the immediate target, and then see if we can eventually reach somewhere around 64.85 to about 65.30. with any pullback still viewing the support, somewhere around 62.80 to 63.30. A bullish outside day for also, or an engulfing candle for Euro, after the market holding in its down channel, now looks back to the top side of the range, which is seen somewhere around 106.50. I do feel though the market may actually just tease a little bit to that top side and look around 106.75. We're still, from a technical point, holding relatively strong, I feel, due to the MACD breaking through the midway point and also the RSI also does support the upside case for this week. To some surprise, the yen was weaker as the dollar rebounded, but nevertheless, the market's still a little bit nervous after a possible intervention from the BOJ after tackling that level around 150. The market was very whipsawed, and no doubt, again, if we approach that level to the top side or anywhere from 150, what a game find. The market being a little bit somewhat heavy due to possible reversal. We're still looking down towards 146.80 and maybe a little bit lower down towards the region of the base coming in at 144.5, so we should not rule that out. With the dollar, as I mentioned, weakening, and also with the sterling posting an engulfing candle from the lows of 120 and now posting another strong candle, looks towards this next level, which is seen around 122.70. Break above there would see the next challenge, which is where this downtrend comes in, around 124. In light of the technicals, they are firming, so I do feel they'll be a little bit more weaker to the dollar and a firmer outcome possibly for some of these currencies. A strong engulfing candle also for gold. Now, I did mention last week there were bids forming, or appear to be, around that low 1,800 from the rebound, and also this engulfing candle could see further gains if we clear the top side level, which is seen at 1,836 to 38. Clearing that level would see further gains up towards 1,845 to 46, or maybe just a touch higher. Nevertheless, the market still will find plenty of resistance around 65 or 1865. Wrapping up with oil, the market is still pressing on this downside level, which is around $81.15 after printing a low of $80.60 and bounced. Nevertheless, the technicals are still heavy. There is a trend to support the bear case. So I do feel there could be a move towards the region, not at 81, but towards 78.80 to 79.40. Well, that's a wrap. Thank you very much for joining me. And as always, look out for the intraday report. I hope you enjoy the great start to the new week.